Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So today I want to talk about influencing the good. Influencing the good. I really love all the topics by all the speakers because I feel so passionate about ensuring that we don't share things that we don't know, we can't verify. I'm also very passionate about what Ustaz Khair Anwar just spoke about dealing with our differences, embracing it. I've done programs and talks about it. I've done postings, very long rants on social media about it. I just feel that we can do better if we were together and if we took the time to learn about each other rather than judging and criticizing, condemning each other. Especially when you're online, the easiest thing to do is to just judge without fully trying to, you know, see what is this person really like? What is this person's background? How was this person raised? What traumatic events, you know, could have shaped this person's past and their path today? Today I want to talk about influencing the good. And let me start with this because I know I have only 15 minutes. In Islam, there is this very well-known principle where we are all encouraged to enjoin others to do good, al-amru bil ma'ruf, and to try to prohibit and deter others from doing things that are wrong, that are bad. وَالنَّهْيُ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And this is something that we, as Muslims, must attempt to do, which is, in our small little ways, are we doing something in which it is trying to get others to do good deeds as well? And good deeds are not limited to just prayers and fasting and charity, but it can be anything. Are we doing it on a daily basis, consciously or unconsciously? And are we also trying to prevent others from doing anything that may harm others or themselves? I have a question, and I often ask this question, which is easier to do? Ajak orang buat baik ataupun larang orang buat jahat? Which one is easier? You see, this is true, right? Have you ever seen a friend who wants to do something bad and you're like, nak tegur ke tak nak? Nak tegur ke tak nak? Should I not? How would this person take it? Would they feel offended? Would I say the wrong thing? Would it affect our friendship? But when you want to ajak someone to do good, usually it's easier. Although I have heard some friends who say, susah lah, it's very tough. You know, when I ask my friends to tag along to, you know, religious events and talks, some of them start labeling me and they say, engkau ni step baik eh? Since when you become an angel? I remember you in the past, you were like paling nakal dalam kelas. You know, in school, you were notorious for certain bad habits and cases. And so now all I'm saying is that there is a problem everywhere, regardless. Kan? It's challenging to try to practice amar ma'ruf and nahi munkar. However, today, we see a lot of people, they dream to become an influencer of some kind. And social media gives you the platform. Social media does not need, you to have or to prove that you have a master's degree or you have a specialization in something or a PhD. They don't need all of these certificates. If you are good enough and you have a strong following, or perhaps you can produce good content, you can become an influencer. And when I was looking for what defines an influencer, you can see on the screen here, it says that, you know, an influencer, surprisingly, number one, it says it's a person. Wow. An influencer is a person. And it's somebody who expresses a contextually relevant message. If you have a relevant message, you will become a relevant person. Okay. Do you have a relevant message? Do you feel strongly and passionately about something that others can relate to? Is your message meaningful enough? That's another important thing. Last year at Spiritual Summit, Safina Spiritual Summit, the talk was themed The Search for Meaning. And this is because we have been receiving a lot of inquiries, people asking, what is the meaning of my job? Why do I have to wake up so early in the morning? Why do I have to finish 4 years of study in order to graduate? So what? So that my parents are happy? What is the meaning behind that? Ustaz, I pray 5 times a day. I barely understand much of what I'm reading. What is the point of that? People are always wondering what's meaningful to their life vis-a-vis the practices that they do. And so if we can share with people what is the meaning of everything that they do in life, even if it's in a specific area, then you will become an influencer. And last but not least, do you ignite and inspire action from other people? Generally, people understand what an influencer is, that when they do a makeup tutorial, then they promote the makeup somewhere in between the brand, and then people will buy. And then, you know, and then people who, let's say, you know, they talk about any random thing, but then they you know, there's a mug in front of them with a certain brand, and that promotes the brand as well. You're an influencer. If you can ignite people to take action, if somebody says, let's say Ustaz Faris, he promotes something and says, hey guys, please sign up for this upcoming event by Muslim SG, and then suddenly, immediately after his posting, you see 30 people signing up. You know, that's an example of igniting action and inspiring people to do something as a follow-up. It's not just passive. Our smartphones equals life, almost, for most people. Like, if they were to lose money, if they were to lose their house, but if they still manage to save their phone, they're like, I'm still okay, I'm still good. I can update, my house has been burned down, you know? This is how sad it looks like. You see, sometimes people wonder, like, hey, if you were dropped in an island somewhere, what would you have with you? And then most people will say smartphone. And until I tell them, but there's no network, and then they're like, oh, okay, fine. So to become an ambassador of good is really easy. There's social media, there are messaging apps, like it was mentioned earlier by Ustaza, like WhatsApp. Ustaz was mentioning about Telegram earlier also when we were talking. And what else is going to come in the future, we don't know. I would also like to remind everyone, when you want to do something like this, what's most important, as what Islam always tells us, that intention is crucial. Why do you want to do this? Why do you want to spread goodness? Why do you want to inspire action from others to do something good? The underlying intention and motive is super important, okay? For example, maybe you want to do this to create a positive impact in society, which is a noble intention. Can you see a problem in society? You see a problem amongst youths, and you say the youths need something better. They need a positive influencer. They need better activities, and then you create a movement or a cause with that underlying intention. MashaAllah, if you do something like that, and even if it garners a small response, a slow response, the great thing is Allah looks at the intention, the purity of your purpose, not so much in the quantity and the size. So if you've started, keep going, and if you've not started, begin to consider. Another one is, maybe you are interested to leave a legacy, okay? Like before you die, you know, if people continue to practice what you learn, then you'll be rewarded. And it links with the last point as well. Okay, so here's the thing. If you want to start influencing the good, you don't need much to start with, right? For example, you need a few skills. Maybe you're good in writing, and today, you know, you don't need to be able to write long, beautiful essays or to write a novel to be able to be an influencer on social media, right? Who's the author of Harry Potter? What's her name? J.K. Rowling, thank you. The fastest answer goes to Ustaz Ridwan. Big fan, okay? So J.K. Rowling, nowadays, she tweets a lot. She can write, you know, like volumes of books, but she can also tweet and very impactful. And so the skill of writing is something I always recommend. Anybody who comes to intern at Safina, I always tell them, if you know how to write really well, you can go far in your life. Whether it is short social media posts, whether it is writing proposals or writing long essays or writing a textbook, whatever projects that come in, just try, because you're going to learn so much. And I think the best platform for you to start with is Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. Just start somewhere. Maybe for you, you're good in photography, take nice photos when you travel, or interesting photos of local people. Maybe to influence and inspire others to do good, you capture people in the act of doing good. And then that can move people's hearts, and it will inspire them to do something on their own as well. Speak. If you're comfortable in front of the camera, which I am not actually, I have done so many times, you know, when, like in 2013, 2014, Safina, we tried to do online, you know, this was a long time ago. I remember recording myself so many times and then editing for hours and then saying, you know what, I don't like this, delete, you know. I just don't like, but when people capture me, it's fine, I guess. When I'm doing something good, lah, okay, when they capture me. And then finally, share. If you think, Ustaz, I'm not good at writing, I'm not good at taking pictures or videos of myself, but you know what? I have a decent following for whatever reason, maybe a few hundred people, a few thousand people. Just share someone else's good work. Right? If you share someone else's good work, inshallah, you'll be rewarded as well. I'll share with you the proof. So, you know, just now, Ustazah was, was talking about, you know, sometimes I do this. I do the question feature on Instagram. So, in since they launched this, and to me, I always like to try anything new that is released by all the social media networks, companies. Remember in 2016 when Facebook launched Facebook Live for the very first time, immediately I launched something called Soul Academy, and I just continued doing it. Like almost every night I would be in front of the camera, penat-penat malam-malam the whole day, and I would do these live sessions to engage with people, just to explore this new platform. And when the Instagram released this, which is about the questions, I started using it, and I noticed that every time I ask, is there a question about something? Usually there are like so many questions that come in to the point where, you know, you can't possibly answer all of them. And I've asked anything from, you know, toxic relationships, questions about solat. This was the most popular, paling banyak orang tanya pasal solat. And I think it's a good thing that people want to know. So the next few slides, bear with me, are all pictures of me. But I just want to share that I've talked about failure, about forgiveness, and look at the kind of questions that people ask. These are all in my highlights, so if you go there, you can still watch them. This is about self-love, about expectations that people have on you. This is about dealing with, figuring out what is my calling in life. And this is all questions on matters of the heart. There's something about jealousy here. I've even done something technical, like about writing. What are your tips on writing? And then this is family conflicts, quite a number of views for this one. And to encourage you, I would like to bring you back to the tradition of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he said in the hadith, "Man da'a ila huda kana lahu min al-ajri mithla ujuri man tabi'ahu la yanqusu dhalika min ujurihim shay'a," which means whoever calls others, da'a, which the word da'wah is derived from, upon the path of guidance, for him he shall receive the same reward as the rewards of those who followed him. So for example, in the three options I gave earlier, which is either to write or to speak or to share, even if your job was only to share, you'll be rewarded the same reward as others. Let's say you couldn't attend today's event, but you were able to share. There's some people on IG Live, and so you wanted to come today, but you were not able to come, but you shared this poster and others came because of your sharing, you get rewarded as though you were here. And you are not taking away any of the people's rewards. Allah will still give you your own reward, mashallah. Right? So the more I give in advice and exhortations, the more I get in love and reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another similar hadith, also narrated by Imam Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sanna fil islami sunnatan hasanatan kana lahu ajruha wa ajru man amila biha min ba'dih la yanqusu dhalika min ujurihim shay'a." The one who initiates a good practice in Islam has his reward, and a reward similar to those who follow him in it until the day of judgment. Isn't that nice? Imagine yourself being in the grave, and you know that you are helpless, you can't do any more good deeds. But you know what? The Prophet ﷺ said, if you were somebody who initiated a good deed that others continue to do till this very day, till the day of judgment, then you will be rewarded forever. Isn't that nice? Would you want that, my dear friends? Yes? Yes. But the opposite is also true. Just to end this very quickly, man sanna fil islami sunnatan sayi'a, whoever initiates a practice of misguidance would be sinful for it and has sinned similar to those who follow him in it until the day of judgment. Don't share what I cannot verify, and don't spread negativity or rumours or ill content. I really cannot stand when people sit around and membawang, like what you said. Kadang-kadang I get so uncomfortable and I get off the table. Sometimes during Hari Raya also people do this, and it's less very uncomfortable. I try to sit for less than 5 minutes and then I just walk away. If it's rude, it's rude, but I just feel like it's not right for us to do that, especially when we don't know. Abu Mas'ud reported, a man came to the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, and said, "My animal has died, so help me, Ya Rasulullah." The Prophet said, "But I do not have anything." But another man who was overhearing the conversation said, "Ya Rasulullah, I can show him someone who can help him." And the Prophet ﷺ said, "Whoever guides someone to goodness will have a similar reward." See, all that third person did was he overheard, somebody needed help. I know, I cannot help too. The Prophet couldn't help, I cannot help, but I know someone who can. And so please, come. So next time, kalau, you know, you have a question and Ustaz Mizi says, "I cannot answer," then I say, go to Ustaz Khairul Anwar, like that. And in the Quran, Allah says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, وَتَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. And enjoin one another, help one another towards goodness and heedfulness. This is very important. I just need to share this. I'm sorry for the ones watching the time. So 2 years ago, Ustaz Khairul Anwar responded to my idea, my suggestion to do Life Tazkira Challenge. This was done on Facebook. And look at, it was just a simple initiative, but the number of engagement, like 60 shares, is pretty impressive. And what's wonderful is that I have other wonderful friends yang layan, you know. You see Ustaz Nuzhan, Ustaz Zulkifli, Ustaz Zahid Zain, Ustaz Khairul Amri, and Ustaz Fadli Ayub, and many others who entertain. We started to just, you know, tag one another, and then, you know, it kept on going and going and going. So what my point is, you can do it even in your own way, small little way, challenge, create a challenge that's positive. Jangan benda-benda epik lah, right? A challenge that actually adds benefit to other people's lives. It can be merepek as in fun, but with a positive outcome, right? And it all started with a simple sabo. I said it would be nice if our satiza took turns to give about 10-minute short tazkira FB Live each day, especially today, a pre-sermon. So when Ustaz did that, it was a Friday. Dia tengah sibuk-sibuk, dia dapat buat 5 minutes video. So I said, for a start, I'd like to sabo nominate Ustaz Khairul Anwar, and he layan. Thank you so much, Ustaz. If you knew your next post will be your last one, have you ever seen news of somebody passing away on social media, and then curiously you just visit your page? I do that sometimes. Because why? For my own reflection, not to judge people. And I look at, wow, what was this person's last post about? So the next time I want to post anything ridiculous, anything that I cannot verify, anything that is a rumor, a gossip, I think back, do I want that to be my last post before I die? So if you knew your next post will be your last one, your last chance to leave behind a positive message, my question to you is, what would you say? And what are you waiting for? Thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.